Jillian Dunn always liked working with her hands, doing art projects and helping her parents with DIY projects. She just wasn't sure what to do with that interest when she got to college.
In high school, I didn't really know what I wanted to do. But people said engineering would be good for you if you like math and science. So I said, yeah, okay, sure. I came here for a visit, and that was the last visit I went on. It was perfect. I just love the campus. I love the feel. I knew it was going to be a really good school. Give me a good education.
The senior from Mason City may not have known where her engineering degree would lead, but she knew she wanted a career where she could develop close relationships with the people she was helping.
I always knew I wanted to help people. I also am a Special Olympics coach here in Ames, and I was building all those relationships, and I really, my favorite part of the week was spending time with my Special Olympics athletes and building those relationships. So I decided I want to have a career where I can be directly building relationships with people.
Volunteering and building those relationships helped Dunn find her path toward prosthetics.
I actually met my friend Daniel, who was the prosthetist. I met him through Special Olympics. He told me all about the prosthetics field. And from there, I decided that I want to be a prosthetist.
And Dunn wasted no time pursuing that dream, spending this past summer in Nashville working at a nonprofit that makes blade prosthetics for amputee athletes.
And there I got to shadow prosthetist. I got to see the fabrication side of prosthetics. I even got to fabricate some of my own. And it was really cool to work with these really, really competitive, highly active, athletic amputees. I would go to work every single day and learn so much.
She also spent part of the summer in Ecuador on a volunteer trip with the Range of Motion Project, providing prosthetic care to those without access to those services.
Worked with some of the local prosthetists, and we ended up having 15 total patients from Ecuador, from around the area we were in, and we fit them with prosthetics. So being able to give them a prosthetic that they can comfortably walk on, finally get back to just living their life was really cool.
As her time at Iowa State winds down, Dunn remains committed to helping people and building relationships, and she's found the perfect career for her to do just that.
This is what I'm meant to do. I'm passionate about this. I know I can go to work every day, be excited about helping people. It's been a long journey, a long, exciting, fun-filled journey, but I am ready for my next adventure.
For Iowa State News Service, I'm Dave Olson.